58.4 volts.
What is up, guys? Welcome back to part 5 of the Razor Ground Force Drift Kart project. At this point, I want more power, but the stock motor hasn't given up quite yet. So we're gonna see if we can force more juice out of it by sticking a 52 volt battery on the current controller and see if we can force it to put down more power and go a little faster before we burn out the stock motor. This is a 52 volt 20 amp hour battery by CalMM. It's got a 50 amp BMS. This is what I usually use on like my Razor MX650 setups on the early days. I'm just gonna mock up a quick adapter to convert this thing to XT60 so that we can connect to this controller and see if this thing's even gonna work. I really have no idea if this is gonna work because I've never tried running 52 volts before on this controller. We'll find out. Far so good. 58.4 volts. Find out. Let's strap this thing on and see if it actually puts the power down. I know it looks a little hood, but I just used some Velcro straps to hold it down in place, but it's not gonna go anywhere. Let's go take this thing out and see if it works.
Might not burn out. It's just, it still doesn't have enough grip. You can only get so much torque out of the stock motor.
Right.
So I think the best move is just to go with a bigger motor.
I would. Fucking just do it if he's driving me, I think.
So this thing certainly makes a lot more power, but it still has limited torque due to the small motor. So it's definitely time to upgrade to a larger one. And the front tires are still a huge limiting factor. I wish I would have more grip on the front so that it can handle better. All right, well, I'm done messing around. It's time for the next phase. Decided to switch out the factory 250 watt brush motor for this 2000 watt brushless motor by Vever. And we're gonna be swapping out the 500 watt controller for this 2000 watt controller by Vever, which we're gonna be modifying to put down more torque. If you are interested in checking out this kit, I'll have it linked in the description below. I think it's a little over $100.
Okay, let's start taking this thing back apart. Got all the wiring tucked inside the seat, which we modified to have the built-in brake light, and I was also able to slide it back 2 inches. And I'm definitely planning on replacing this rusty chain with a brand new one. Still gonna be a 25H chain since we're gonna go with a MY1020 motor. Razor has some weird sizes sometimes. The motor mount bolt is a 16 millimeter and then the nut is a 17. It's very rare that I use my 16 millimeter wrench, unless it's on my BMW. Other than that, I rarely use a 16. Just to give you guys some perspective on the dimension differences between the stock motor and the new motor, it is certainly much larger. Hopefully we don't have any trouble fitting this. I'm definitely gonna have to modify the mounting bracket for the motor. I might have to re-drill this one like I did on the Tesla project. So here's what I'm thinking. This position seems to work well with lining up with the axle sprocket. But I was actually thinking that I was gonna mount a battery here, but that's a little bit limited on space. Since I slid the seat back 2 inches, there's not too much room as far as width. I probably have 6x7. Let me know if you guys have a suggestion for at least a 48 volt or 52 volt battery that'll fit in this general area. So I might just end up mounting the controller on the back side of the seat or on top of the battery. Let me know what you guys think.
If you are interested in checking out the next phase for the Razor Ground Force go-kart project, make sure you stay tuned to this channel, but it's likely gonna be a couple weeks since I just got my nuclear controller upgrade for the Tellaria XXX, and I'm anxious to see what kind of changes those make. So we're likely gonna be working on this bike this week. But if you enjoyed today's video, do me a favor and hit that like button. And if you like this kind of content, want to keep up with some of my projects, such as my Tellaria or my Razor projects, my big Yamaha, consider subscribing to this channel. But this is going to be it for today. Thank you for watching.